Okay, interior, Giacomo's pizzeria, night. In the midst of service, Paul Giacomo gazes a cautious eye over two pizzas cooking in a steel oven. Beads of sweat roll from his crinkled, balding head as he snaps the oven shut 2 more minutes. He lassos his protruding stomach contained by a food-stained penny to his next job when his wife enters.
Order away.
Order away. He's such a nice boy, Marcus. Down to earth, friendly. I think we really need to tell him. I feel so guilty.
Behind a bush of black curly hair and red rosy cheeks, Sue Giacomo operates front of house with a warm and friendly glow.
No, we say nothing.
But he's a professional athlete worth millions of pounds. If it comes out that his favourite pizza place has a rat, it's over.
It was an isolated incident and it has now been dealt with.
It better be.
Sue leaves to go back on the floor.
I've got more rats.
What?
Having clumsily entered from the back door, Josh Giacomo dumps his delivery bag and wrestles off his cycle helmet with barely any grace.
Just seen 5 of the bastards loitering out next to the bins.
On the flush of a toilet, Louis enters now drying his hands. Pencil thin and with a spotless penny, he takes up his position at the pizza operations desk while Josh continues to garble.
It's a damn good job I got my hands on these bad boys, okay? This pile of evil is designed to decapitate intestines and burn through the stomach walls of whoever it comes to.
Josh holds a small open Tupperware box next to Louis.
I hope not, because I've just put that on Rashford's pizza.
You haven't.
I hope you're joking.
No, I'm not. It's new to sausage, Dad. It's not poison.
Paul smells it and recoils slightly.
But ain't no one do ya.
Told you. Rat poison.
What have you done, Louis?
What do you mean, what have I done? Here's the one who brought poison into a working kitchen.
Yeah, but I didn't expect you to serve it to England's best centre forward.
Paul begins to pace, lost in his own personal torment.
What are we going to do?
It looks identical, Josh. Same colour, same size, even same type of box.
Now you mention it, that is a tad tricky.
A tad tricky?
Louis goes for Josh until...
Will you please shut up? I'm trying to think.
You need to tell Mum.
No. We've only got a small window of time. Josh, what type of poison is it?
It's called Chernobyl's Kiss.
Oh, Christ.
Sue enters.
All okay back here? I'm waiting on a few orders.
Fine.
Sue moves back to front of house, eyeing her family suspiciously.
All right, got it off the internet, Dad, okay? Good deal, actually. Delivered on time.
This is not a bloody review on Amazon, Josh. If Marcus eats the pizza, what's going to happen?
Okay. It says, and I quote, one ingested thumbnail portion of Chernobyl's Kiss will not only eliminate the pesky rodent, but its toxic makeup also has the ability to wipe out foxes, pigs, and even small deer.
One thumbnail portion can wipe out a deer? How much did you put on the pizza?
About 20.
How much?
About 20. It's not more than our usual serving.
Certainly sounds like he's going to put him out of the match on Saturday, though.
Oh, are you sure? Here's me thinking he can possibly run it off. You're an idiot. It could well end his career.
Suddenly, Sue bounds in, flustered and stressed.
The customer's collapsed.
What?
He's writhing around on the floor. What do I do?
There can't be more.
Shit. I don't know. No, I don't think so. I may have used it earlier, but...
What should I do?
Can you tell if his intestines are decapitated?
Why the hell do I need to know that?
Nothing, no. Look, just get back out there, phone an ambulance, and don't panic.
Sue disappears back into the breach.
Right, Josh, get on your bike and get after Marcus. There's roadwork scattered for miles here and he couldn't have got far. Once you find him, follow him.
Follow him. I'm on a cycle, you'll be in a supercar.
Don't want to hear it. Mum knows where he lives. Ask her on the way out.
Got it.
Josh sprints off.
What are we going to do?
Serve pizza.
Paul gets the pizzas out of the oven, trying to act normal.
Can't serve pizza at a time like this.
We need to carry on like nothing has happened.
Oh, of course. Sorry, madam. Please ignore the convulsing gentleman bleeding at the eyeballs. Here's your pepperoni. Enjoy.
The ambulance has arrived.
Sue is back.
He's not dead, is he?
No, but he's not in a good shape. Foaming at the mouth. Where's Josh gone?
Oh, I knew it. I just knew it.
Okay, get out there. Try and settle the customers we have left. Oh, and by the way, if you have seen any other Nduja specials out there, destroy them.
Confused, Sue disappears to calm the scene.
I knew it.
You what?
It's a sign. All this, it's a sign that I shouldn't be doing it.
Come on now, Louis, easy. I remember my first few days with your granddad. Pizza came out of the oven looking like a vinyl. Don't let one little setback get you down.
One little setback? I could be done for manslaughter here, Dad. I'm done. I'm over this.
Louis takes off his penny.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means I quit. I want more than this, Dad.
More? This is a 50-year institution handed down through multiple Giacomos.
I know, and I get that. That's why I'm telling you now.
Now? Of all times?
I'm sorry.
No, I'm not having it. You're not going anywhere. I need you.
You've got Josh.
He brought inedible death onto the ingredients board. You're the brain's head screwed on. Josh is well different.
Give him a chance. He'll prove himself. He's bright.
Paul's phone rings. It's Josh on speakerphone.
You find him?
Yeah.
Has he eaten a pizza?
I can't tell.
Why not?
I'm just climbing over his fence.
Get the hell down.
Oh, shit. There's someone coming.
The lion goes dead.
And you think he can help run this ship?
Yes. It may go through choppy water more often than not, but yes.
He hasn't got a clue.
I don't. Sure you didn't. And Papa before... But there's one thing you can't question.
What?
He cares.
What you don't?
No.
This breaks Paul.
No, what I mean is, I do care. Of course I care, but just not enough. I want to go to university, study. I'm not made for this.
I don't care if you're not made for it. You're doing it. I can't afford to lose you, gallivanting around campus carefree.
I will be studying, not gallivanting.
What will you be studying? How to get pissed and eat kebabs?
Are you just being childish? I want to be a doctor. Look, I can either stay here, filled with regret and angst, studying the family tradition, or go try and make a difference.
Stay. I'm good with that. Angst and regret never hurt anybody.
I've told Mum.
Oh, so you're ganging up on me?
No, not at all. I've wanted to tell you for ages, but...
Sue enters, looking calmer this time.
Ambulance is gone. Customers have settled back down. What's with you two?
Do we know what happened?
Yeah.
Oh, God, it's the end. Who cares now, Louise? It's over. Papa, forgive me.
He choked.
He choked?
Yes. In all the panic, I couldn't see what was going on. Someone threw on the Heimlich and it was over.
He choked. He choked. Yes, he choked. Yes.
What the bloody hell is the matter with you?
One down or one to go. Josh, come on, where are you?
Where is Josh?
He's on a delivery.
He's breaking and entering.
He's what? Why?
Well, let's not go into that.
What is going on, Paul?
Nothing. All fine here.
Rubbish. Something is going on and I want to know.
Paul sits down. He knows he can't hide it from his wife any longer.
I failed. Josh, he's on the brink of a criminal record. This one wants to desert us, and now we've got five rats.
Five?
And?
There's an and?
Paul can't bring himself to admit it again.
There's been an incident. It appears I mistakenly put poison on Marcus's pizza. Josh got some off the internet to kill the rats, and it got mixed up. He's currently trying to retrieve it.
By breaking into his house? Why didn't you call him? I've got his number.
Paul is on his feet.
Why didn't you say?
I was too busy dealing with a choking customer. And let me see this poison.
It's over there.
Sue checks it over.
This?
Louis and Paul nod.
This isn't poison. This is sausage. I forgot to say I ordered it on Monday. It's a dry cured kielbasa. Thought we could try. It smells a bit weird though.
Paul and Louis can barely contain their jaw from hitting the floor.
You're telling me we've gone through all of this for nothing?
I think so. All you've done, Louis, is put kielbasa on instead of Nduja.
Paul runs and hugs Sue.
What about the poison?
The box with the skull on the front. I put it in the safe. Can't believe in that in the kitchen. Anything could happen.
Oh, Jesus, dear, you are a lifesaver.
You need a pay rise.
Absolutely, and even better, it means you can stay.
No, that's still not happening.
Tell him, Sue.
Nope, this is your hang-up, Paul. Papa may have forced it upon you, but I won't let you carry that on. You want Louis to be happy, don't you?
Yes, of course, but I want him to be happy here.
And I will be, just during the holidays.
Paul contemplates. He knows this was going to come, and now he has to swallow it down and accept it.
You are too good for this place. In fact, you both are. I never got the qualifications you got because your granddad had me in here. Spent every waking hour with him. Loved it more than the pizza. I just don't want to lose what I had.
And you won't. You're not losing me just because we're not slinging dough side by side.
Feels like it.
I can get a cardboard cut out of me if you want. Don't know how it will work, the pizza slicer though.
Pizza off.
They both laugh.
I need to do this, Dad.
I know, son, I get it. It's fine. Go swap your stagioni for a stethoscope. I'm proud of you.
They hug. Sue joins in as well.
There's someone missing from this hug.
Christ, where is he?
Just as Paul swipes on his phone, Josh staggers in looking dirty, his jeans half ripped up.
What happened to you?
Got chased by three Safis.
Oh, goodness me, are you okay?
Didn't know Marcus had dogs?
Yeah, not these type. I was at the wrong house. Some meathead drug dealer came out and let them free. Look, the damn things just wouldn't stop.
They must have been rabid.
Either that, or it's just the smell I have because of the sausage. Look, I'm sorry I let you down, Dad.
Hey, I don't want to hear it. You didn't let me down. I'm proud of you. In fact, you're getting promoted. We need to talk.
Well, what about the poison?
It wasn't poison.
I stored your little package in the safe.
Thank God for that. Where is it? I'll get some laid out in the back now.
I think we'll leave that to the professionals.
Agreed.
Good, because there's 12 of them now.
12?
Together, the Giacomo family storm out the back in a renewed pursuit of eradicating their rodent neighbours. The end.